It's Monday, May the 3rd of the year of the Lord 2021. The Church celebrates today the feast of Saints Philip and James, two of the disciples of Jesus Christ. And the Gospel is taken from St. John, chapter 14, verse 6 to 14. Jesus said to Thomas, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." Philip said to him, "Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us." Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing his work, his works. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father is in me, or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen. I say to you, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than this, because I am going to the Father. And whatever you ask in my name, I will do, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything of me in my name, I will do it." The Gospel of the Lord. We are in this particular section of the Gospel of John, which goes from chapter 14 to 17. You can see the big farewell of Jesus to his disciples. He is in the Last Supper, which is in chapter 13. Now Jesus is tackling different issues. And now this is about Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. There is no other means to go to the Father but through Jesus. The one who came down from heaven is going up, went up to heaven. And he is the one who leads us, the one who connects us with the Father, because Jesus is God like the Father, he is a human like us. So he's the bridge between the Father and us humans. So truly human and truly divine. This is our faith that we profess every Sunday with the Creed. So he is the way, he is also the truth at the end, because he's the one who reveals who the Father is. He reveals the truth of the divinity, but also the truth of humanity, who we humans are, what is our true self. It's not what the world says, but what God says. To be really humans is to be really divine. To be really humans is to be Christ-like. And then he is the life. And constantly in the Gospel of John repeats the same. If you believe in me, you will have life everlasting, the fullness of life. And then the second aspect, there is that unity between the Father and the Son, which is repeated constantly in today's passage at the end. No? If you don't know him and have seen him, the one who sees Jesus sees the Father. And Jesus has come to do the work of his Father. Believing in Jesus is believing in the Father at the end. Jesus is in the Father, and the Father is in me. Which is what we believe in the dogma of the Trinity. No? Jesus is God like the Father. And the Father is the Father of Jesus, the Son of God. That unity between the Father and the Son. Two persons, one God. And then you include the Holy Spirit, three different persons, but one God. So let us remember, there is no other way to go to the Father but through Jesus Christ, our Savior. And today, as we celebrate this feast of the two apostles, remember that we profess that the Church is one, holy, Catholic, and apostolic. And it's apostolic because of two things, of the teaching of the apostles, what we believe about Jesus is what the apostles learned and taught us, and it's apostolic because of the ministry, the apostolic succession from the apostles to the bishops to even today, to the ministry with the priests and the bishops. Apostolic in the teaching, apostolic in the ministry. Have a blessed Monday, And may God bless you today and always. Amen.